determine percent markup on cost and the equivalent markup on selling price. Sometimes a markup based on cost must be compared with a markup based on selling price. For example, a salesperson who sells to both manufacturers, which use markup on cost, and to retailers, which use markup on selling price, might have to make conversions from one markup method to the other. And here we have an example. We're given our cost and selling price, and the questions being asked are to determine the markup based on cost and the markup based on selling price. So we're using our foundation formula for selling price. Because on the left-hand side we're dealing with the markup based on cost, our 100% and base value will be there. On the right-hand side, we're using our selling price formula and placing the 100% and base associated with the selling price because we're dealing with markup based on selling price. Cost of this item is the same. The selling price is the same. But because our markup is based on cost in one and selling price in the other, we'll find that that markup rate is going to be different. From the selling price and the cost, we can find our markup by subtracting cost from selling price, and everything looks the same, but it's because on the left-hand side we have our markup based on cost, we end up with a part divided by base to come up with a rate, and converting this into a percentage gives us a 51.4%. And on the right-hand side, with our percent markup based on selling price, when we're looking for the rate and have the part and the base, the resulting rate is 33.9%. As far as the consumer is concerned, and actually even the business or retailer, their markup amount dollar-wise are the same, but the percentage markup is different due to where that base amount is. We have another problem similar to the last one. We're given a cost and selling price and asking us to calculate the markup based on both cost and selling price. So we have our two formulas. The location of our base is dependent upon the percent markup, cost on the left and selling price on the right. We're given the cost, we're given the selling price. Knowing cost and selling price, we can subtract the cost from selling price to give us our markup amount, in both cases being the same. And dollar for dollar again, it looks very similar. But over here, to determine the percent markup based on cost, we're looking for a rate, we have a part, and we have our base. To find a rate, we will take part divided by base. Converting this into a percentage, it would end up being a 2, but that's not a percentage. We always get a rate. We need to convert it into a percent. Moving the decimal over 2 gives us a 200% markup based on cost. And on the selling price side, percent markup based on selling price, again, we're looking for rate. Our part is the same, $10.30, but our selling price is different than the previous calculation and results in a 66.7%. Some people in the retail business use markup on cost and others use markup on selling price. Neither is better than the other. The two just represent different ways to talk about the same thing. Some companies and managers tend to use one of them, and other companies and managers tend to use the other. We have another method for markup comparisons is to use a conversion formula. And here we have the formula if we're looking to convert from a percent markup based on cost to a percent markup based on retail. We need to know our percent markup on cost. We'll take that divided by 100% plus the percent markup on cost to give us an equivalent selling price. And let's take a look at converting our markup based on cost to an equivalent percent markup based on selling price. So here we have our formula for converting markup percent on cost to markup percent on selling price. We're given a 30% markup based on cost. Plugging that into our formula, we have a 30%, 100% plus that percent markup on cost again, simplifying the denominator, and while we're at it, converting these percentages to an equivalent decimal, doing the division, and last, we will convert this decimal to a percent, rounding it to the nearest tenth. An equivalent markup based on selling price is 23.1% to the given 30% markup based on cost. We have another example given 18% markup based on cost. They're asking us to find an equivalent percent markup based on selling price. Using the formula for converting a markup percent on cost to a markup percent on selling price, we will replace the percent markup on cost given as 18%, simplify the denominator, convert our percents into decimals at the same time, and last, we will take the numerator 0.18 divided by 1.18, giving us the following decimal, and last step, convert this decimal into a percent to answer the question. We can also go the other direction. If we are given a markup based on selling price, we use the following formula to determine an equivalent percent markup on cost. And here we have an example given 12% markup based on selling price is the same as what percent markup based on cost. We'll use our converting markup percent on selling price to markup percent on cost formula, where we need to know our markup based on selling price. We're given that value in the problem, replacing those variables. And if you notice, slight difference in the formula with the fact that the denominator is a subtraction or a difference rather than the addition when we're going from a percent cost to a percent selling price. So simplifying the denominator, 100% minus 12% is 88%. Also, these are being converted from percents to an equivalent decimal. Taking the numerator, 0.12 divided by the denominator, 0.88 gives us the following decimal. Converting this decimal into an equivalent percent, we move our decimal two places to the right. So we would answer this question with 13.6%. Another problem here of converting from a percent markup based on selling price to an equivalent percent markup based on cost. We will use that converting markup percent on selling price to markup percent on cost formula. We have a markup of 80% based on selling price. That'll go in the numerator. Over 100 minus that 80% in the denominator. 100% minus 80% simplified in the denominator gives us a 0.20, actually a 20%, but the decimal equivalency is 0.20 or just 0.2. Taking 0.8 divided by 0.2 gives us 4, and you might feel like you're done, but if you think of the previous three problems that we've had, we always are getting a decimal equivalency, so we need to convert this into a percent. And it turns out that an 80% markup based on selling price is equivalent to 400% markup based on cost.